Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this video, I'll be showing you the right way to do this Photoshop dual lighting effect. If you have fun with this video, make sure you hit that like button and also share. You can support this channel through Patreon, and don't forget to subscribe. I'm doing a lot of videos each week. There's my current schedule, and I'm even putting up some more videos on the in-between days as well. You can learn a lot more about working with Photoshop from my complete training course, and there's a link for that right down there in the description. Okay, let's get to it. This dual lighting effect in Photoshop is actually pretty easy to do. Let me just erase all of these layers over here. I'll go back to just the initial file. Just delete those layers out. There we go. So there's the initial file. Now for this to work well, it helps if you have lighting that's kind of on two sides of the face and it's a bit darker in the middle. This lighting is underneath, but it gives us that same basic kind of lighting effect. Now the first thing I want to do is to adjust the values in here on the image. So I'll just do a little adjustment layer for that. Go up to Layer, come down to New Adjustment Layer, and Levels right there. Choose OK. Now in this, I just want to lighten the image up a little bit, so I'll pull the mid-tone here over to the left just a little ways. It doesn't need to go very far. See, that's too far right there, beginning to kind of break things up, but just a little bit, maybe about 150 or so, 155, that's not too bad in there. So just lightening up the image a bit. I'll leave the black and the white sliders alone, and just do all the control here from the mid-tone. Maybe just a little bit lighter, right about there, that looks pretty good. 1.79 for this particular photograph. The setting, of course, will change depending upon the picture that you use, but that's pretty good. I want some nice brights in here and keep the darks fairly dark. It's going a little bit light down there on the bottom. I think that's okay. If you don't like that, you can always do a layer mask on this and just kind of block out some of that area. Let me show you that real fast. When you put in one of these adjustment layers, you automatically get a layer mask. White shows, black hides. So let's just have our black as a foreground color. Grab a paintbrush. I'll use the right bracket to make this a bit larger. And let's set this at a soft brush, so hardness at 0. There we go. And I'll just paint some black right in here, right on top of that layer mask. And then just block out that shirt. There we go. Okay, that's nice and clean now. Let's now put in our coloration. The coloration is all done with just a couple of layers. Go up to Layer, come down to New Fill Layer and Gradient, right there. You can leave that unchecked, that's fine. Choose OK. There's the basic gradient. I'm going to set the angle here to 0, so it gives me a left to right gradient. Click on the gradient itself right here. Let's just choose that one there, just a standard gradient. Purple left-hand side, orange right-hand side, and we'll work with this. We'll bring this back up in just a second, but right now click on OK. Click OK here, and then I want to change the blend mode for this gradient layer right there, and change that to color. That puts the colors into the image without changing anything else. Let's now go back to that gradient, double-click on the thumbnail for that layer, click on the gradient again right here, and now we can work with this and get this set up. The first thing we want is to have transparency in the middle of this image. That's easy to do. Just come over here and just click in the middle someplace. The top row up here, these are your opacity stops. So here's our first one. Set this right at a location of 50, so it's exactly in the middle. And then change the opacity here to 0. Just pull it over like that. 0 opacity. Okay, now we have a lot of nothing in here. And then solid colors on the ends. You need to bring back the opacity on those. So these opacities on the ends here, that one and this one, these are at 100%, and then it's 0 right here. So grab this opacity slider on the left-hand side, pull this left one in all the way over to 37%. You can actually just type that in if you want to. There's 37%. On the right-hand side, bring this one into 61%. There we go, 61%. Now let's match these stops to those stops. This first one here, this was at 37, matches that, so just type in 37, pulls that one in. This stop was at 61, so I'll type that in, 61, and that pulls that stop in. And that sits in our basic dual color. Now if you want to, you can move the transparency stops in a little bit like this, and that just brings down that clear section in the middle. I kind of like those at the same points as the color stops, so I'll just reset those. There we go. And choose OK. Now it's a little bit weak still. We can strengthen this up very easily by duplicating this layer and then changing its blend mode just a little bit. So right click where it says Gradient Fill 1 and choose Duplicate Layer. Choose OK, there we go. Now at this point you're not really seeing a whole lot. If I show and hide this one, there's a little bit more orange right there. Not the effect we're looking for. So change the blend mode here to overlay, and it gets a lot stronger, as you can see there. Way too strong, actually, so let's bring down the opacity on that overlay down to 20%. And there we go. There's without, and there's with. It just kind of richens up those colors. And that's all there is to it. That takes care of this dual color look. And as you can see, pretty easy to do. Now it's getting a little bit light in here. It is kind of down there, a little light here, a little light down there. All you have to do on that is just to take this layer mask down here, hold the Alt key, pull that straight up, and choose Yes. And the same thing one more time, pull it straight up, and choose Yes. And that copies up that layer mask from the first layer here up onto those layers, and that kind of darkens that down just a bit. So there we go. That's the fast, easy way to do this dual color effect. If you want to change your color, because we've done this as fill layers, all you have to do is double click on the thumbnail. That brings the effect back up here. Click on that, and then you can change your color just by clicking on this little icon right there, and there's your color stop. That's the purple. Over here is the orange. Click there and there's a color picker. And there you go. The quick and easy way to do this dual lighting effect.